بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
قد أفلح المؤمنون الذين هم في صلاتهم خاشعون والذين هم
من سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالًا كثيرًا ونساءً، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله، surely the best narrative is the book of Allah، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. The best guidance is that of our Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشر الأمور محدثاتها. And the worst of affairs are those things that we introduce in this deen of ours. وكل بدعة ضلالة. And each innovation leads astray. وكل ضلالة في النار. And each going astray is in the fire. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى هل يستوي الذين يعلمون والذين لا يعلمون. Allah سبحانه وتعالى questions are those who know and those who don't know equal. The response is clear. And in it is an encouragement for the believing brothers and sisters to acquire an understanding of this deen. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم taught us in the hadith by Abi Huraira إذا مات الإنسان انقطع عمله إلا من ثلاثة، إلا من صدقة جارية أو علم ينتفع به أو ولد صالح يدعو له. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم said when a man dies his deeds stop except for three things that benefits him after he passes away. One is صدقة جارية, something good that you do that lasts after your death that people can benefit from. Building a masjid, publishing some books, distributing some of those things that even after your death, people benefit from. Sadaqa jariya, a continual type of charity. Or ilmin yuntafa'u bi, or knowledge that the people benefit from. This is something that abides even after your death. If you taught a person how to recite Surah Al-Fatiha, every time he recites that verse, you get a reward for it. If you taught a person how to perform wudu every time he washes and his sins are wiped away, you get a reward for that. If you teach a person about standing up in the night, even if you sleep, you get a reward for the good that he does. If you guide someone to Islam, every khayr that he does in Islam, you get a reward for. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said beneficial knowledge here is something that benefits you after you die, knowledge of the deen. Or waladun salihun yad'u lahu, or a righteous child, male or female, after the parent passes away, the child supplicates. He supplicates, she supplicates. And here the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam chose supplication over every other act of righteousness. And the reason this was chosen by Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because this is the best that you can do to assist your parents after they pass away. Supplicate for them. Ask Allah to forgive them. Ask Allah to raise their station up. Ask Allah to pardon them. Ask Allah to look away from their sins and wrongs. Three things. And the most important thing is the beneficial knowledge that you leave after. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, الدال على الهدى the person who guides towards, to who leads or directs towards guidance. He gets the reward of everyone who acts upon that guidance. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Every deed that is done in this ummah, every supplication, every word of the Quran, every harf that is recited, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam receives a reward for it. There is a mistake when people pray and they say this reward is for Allah's Messenger. That's a lack of understanding. The fact that you are doing righteousness, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam gets a share of it. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, according to Abi Umama al-Bahili, he said, ذُكِرَ لِرَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَآلِهِ وَسَلَّمُ رَجُلًا أَحَدْهُمَا عَابِدْ وَالْآخَرْ عَالِمٌ. Two people were mentioned to Allah's Messenger صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. One of them given to worship and the other one who was grounded in knowledge in the deen. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, فَضْلُ الْعَالِمْ عَلَى الْعَابِدِ كَفَضْلِ عَلَى أَدْنَاكُمْ. He said, the virtue of the person who has knowledge of this deen over one who worships is like my benefit and virtue over the lowest amongst you. ثُمَّ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ إِنَّ اللَّهِ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ وَأَهْلَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَأَرْضِينَ حَتَّى النَّمْلَ فِي جُحْرِهَا حَتَّى الْحُوتِ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى مُعَلَّمِ النَّاسِ الْقَيْرِ. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم then taught the virtue of acquiring knowledge of this deen and teaching the people goodness. He says, surely Allah, His angels, the inhabitants of the skies, the heavens, and the earth, even an ant in his hole, even the fish in the sea, supplicate to Allah on behalf of the person who teaches mankind goodness. Umur al-Deen. According to Qais ibn Kathir, he said, قَدِمَ رَجُلٌ مِنَ الْمَدِينَةِ عَلَى أَبِي دَرْدَى. A person came from Medina to Abu Darda, who was in Dimash, and he was in Damascus. And he said to him, Abu Darda said to the brother, he says, مَا أَقَدَمَكَ يَا أَخِي, what has brought you this distance, my brother? He says, حَدِيثٌ بَلَغَنِي أَنَّكَ تُحَدِّثُ عَنْ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَعَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. He said, a hadith, one hadith. It has reached me that you narrate from Allah's Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this narration. He said, Amajat to the Hajj? He said, you didn't come for some other need? Faqala Allah. He said, no. He said, Ma qadim to the tijara? You didn't come for some business? Faqala Allah. Jittu fi talab hadha al-hadith. I came to get an understanding in this one hadith that you heard from Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, Abu Darda says, فَإِنِّي سَمِعْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam يَقُولُ. He said, then let me tell you, I heard Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, مَنْ سَلَكَ طَرِيقًا يَبْتَغِي فِيهِ عِلْمًا سَلَكَ اللَّهُ بِهِ طَرِيقًا إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ. I heard Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, whoever goes up seeking knowledge, Allah will put him on a pathway to paradise. And then he said, إِنَّ الْمَلَائِكَ لَتَذَعُوا أَجْنِحَتَهَا رِبًا لِطَالِبِ الْعِلْمِ. Says the angels spread their wings for the person who's traversing and traveling a path to acquire knowledge. And then he said, إِنَّ الْعَالَمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُ لَهُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ. And that the person who has knowledge, everyone in the heavens and on the earth asks forgiveness for him. حَتَّى الْحِيْتَانُ فِي الْمَاءِ, even the fish in the sea. And then the Prophet ﷺ, he says, فَضْلُ الْعَالَمِ عَلَى الْعَابِدِ كَفَضْلِ الْقَمْرِ عَلَى سَائِرِ الْكَوَاكِبِ. The virtue of the scholar over the person who is just given to worship is like the virtue of the moon over the rest of the stars in the sky. Qadi Iyad, when he explained this, he says, the reason for this similitude is that the other stars, the light that they have is located and it is restricted for themselves. But the moon, the radiance that you get from it illuminates the whole dunya. And so the scholar is likened to the moon and not the stars. And then he says, إن العلماء ورثة الأنبياء. The people who have knowledge, they are true inheritors of the prophets. إن الأنبياء لم يورثوا دينارا ولا درهما. They didn't leave the prophets as an inheritance, gold and silver coins, ورثوا العلم. They left knowledge of Allah, knowledge of His deen, the things that will get you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that will allow you to get on the other side safe on Yawm al-Qiyamah. This is what they left with. He says, فَمَنْ أَخَذَ بِهِ أَخَذَ بِحَذٍ وَافٍ. And whoever gets hold of this type of ilm, he has an abundance of good fortune. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taught us what we need to know. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has encouraged us so that we would exert ourselves in this life to be saved in the life. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد, brothers and sisters in Islam, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم said, الدنيا ملعونة والملعونة ما فيها, يعني مذمومة, لأنها تشغل وتبعد عن الله عادة. That this dunya is blameworthy and blameworthy what you have in it. Those things that take you away from the remembrance of Allah. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, إِلَّا ذِكْرَ اللَّهِ, except the remembrance of Allah. وَمَا وَلَّهُ, يعني مَا أَحَبَّهُ اللَّهُ وَمَا قَارَبَهُ مِنْ طَاعَاتِ. Those things that Allah love and those other things that draw you close to the obedience of Allah. وَعَالِمًا وَمُتَعَلِّمًا. And a person who is teaching or the one who is acquiring knowledge of this blessed deen of ours. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the Prophet ﷺ encouraged the believers to go and seek knowledge of the Quran, seek knowledge of the Sunnah. Take it from the people who understand it. Abdullah bin Amr al-As, he said, إِنَّ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَعَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ قَالَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَقَبِدُ الْعِلْمِ انْتِزَاعٍ يَنْتَزِعُ مِنَ الْعِبَادِ. Allah will not take away knowledge just by snatching it away from the slaves. وَلَكِنْ يَقَبِدُ الْعِلْمِ بِقَبْدِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. But He will take knowledge away by taking away the people who understand, who truly understand the Qur'an and the Sunnah. The people who understand the text that we've been given, whose regulations and rulings are not coming from themselves. But when you deal with an issue, they're quoting Allah, they're quoting the authentic Sunnah from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And when people differ on these two, they refer back to the Sahaba, the students who stood at the feet of Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. حتى إذا لم يبق عالما اتخذ الناس رؤوسا جهالا. When you don't have the people of ilm, people take ignorant people as their leaders. فضلوا أضلوا. سئلوا فأفتوا بغير علم. فضلوا أضلوا. And they question and they give religious rulings. Why? Because they feel ashamed to say, I don't know. And they start passing regulations on based on ignorance, they go astray and lead others astray. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, عِلْمًا نَافِعًا, to bless us with beneficial knowledge, وَعَمَلًا صَالِحًا, and to give us righteous deeds, وَرِزْقًا طَيِّبًا, and sustenance that is wholesome and pure, that will assist us in this life and help us on the other side.